Hi, this video is a continuation of how to build your data science portfolio series. And if you have not watched the introduction video about how to build your data science portfolio, you can click the link on the top. So basically, to give a quick gist of it, what we are telling is like there are a lot of data sets available, there are a lot of well-known data set, there are a lot of Kaggle data set. But everybody has access to the data set. So how you can make your portfolio stand out, how you can complement the existing available data set along with alternate data sources. And in the last couple of videos, we have been talking about how to create those alternate data sources. So in the first video, we took a problem that is trending now, analyzing coronavirus across the globe, right? And what we did in the first video is we took data from social media. We were listening to the hashtag coronavirus and seeing like who are the users who are commenting about coronavirus, what are the geolocation. We took the data, we cleaned the tweets that are coming in, we did geo encoding, we did sentiment analysis, we did entity extraction. That was the first video. The second video that we did is we downloaded the data set from John Hopkins repo, which is getting updated in almost whenever they have data, I think twice a day or thrice a day. There were a lot of missing value in the state column. So we did some kind of smart imputation for state column, and also we combined the time series data to make it an ready data frame that can be used in our analysis. That was the second video about. In this video, we are going to more talk about web crawling. So what we are going to do is we are going to go to some website. We are going to crawl the data about coronavirus and then again build a data set. And finally, what you can do from here is you can take these three data sets, and then you can combine it and do analysis. So basically, you are not only taking the regular data set, which is the data from John Hopkins repo, you are complementing it with alternate data sources. Now think about a different use case altogether, right? If you are in an lending business and typically you want to find what is the default rate. Now, default rate is a combination of business parameters as well as micro and macro social economic parameters. So if we can get that micro and macro social economic data, we can infuse it with your regular traditional transactional data, then you may get better insight. So that is the idea over here. So this is just an example to demo how to get it done. So let's get started with the web crawling part. So the very first thing is the three websites I'm going to scrap today is one is the CNN website. So this is the CNN website where the coronavirus data is getting updated. And if you see over here, this website, basically there is a date to it. So what they do is they keep the link the same, but on a daily basis, they append a new date to it. And that's the CNN website. The next one we are going to do is CNBC website, and we are going to use the RSS feed from CNBC website. So the RSS feed is basically an XML file, as you are seeing here, that we are going to download it, and then we are going to take all the latest news that is happening across the globe. That is the second one. The third one that we are going to use is NBC News. So the NBC News, if you see, this is the URL, and this URL does not have any date or something like that. It's a straightforward URL. So this is again HTML page where all the coronavirus related information is talked about. So these are the three websites we are going to scrap. I'm going to first show a simple example and then go into scrapping multiple websites in different format. As you saw over there, one is XML, which is RSS feed, and two are HTML files. And out of that, one has a dynamic URL. Right, so how can we get it done? So what I'm doing is, in order to address a dynamic URL, I am importing the date time package, and then I am creating a date format in the format the URL accepts. So it accepts like 03-12-2020, right? So by a %m, %d, %y is the format, and if I print it, you can see like basically it's showing me 03-12-20. And then I am defining the CNN URL object. I am basically giving the URL. And in this case, what I am doing is I am giving an empty open and close bracket. Basically, I am going to substitute that with the date object that I have created on the top, D object. So basically, what will happen when I run this, it's going to substitute 03-12-20 over here. And you can quickly see this is how it will look like. So this is the URL where the CNN information is there. First, I'm going to just use the CNN information for now, and then I'm going to show you. For scrapping the website, I'm going to use the beautiful soup package, which is available in Python. So I'm just importing from the BS4 package, I'm importing beautiful soup, and I'm importing request object to create the URL. So let me quickly run this. Then I am going to say the request.get this URL that we are defined, the CNN URL, and I'm going to get the text object. So I'm going to get the entire HTML text and assign it to an HTML object. Then I am creating I'm calling the beautiful soup function that we imported on the top. I am passing the HTML, and basically it will create like a soap object where I can go and extract a specific tag. It can be header, it can be title, it can be some kind of div tags or h2 tags. I can do anything. So I am by default printing the soup.title. It will tell the title that is going on in that web page. So it's currently the title is coronavirus US travel bans hits 26 European countries, and that's the latest news, right? Basically there was a news that travel to European countries is banned, right? I am also going to import the Spacy package. The Spacy package I'm going to import is from the headlines. I want to see what is the context they are talking about, right? What are the countries involved? Who are the people involved? Or is there some other known entities involved, right? So that's what the Spacy package is. Spacy is an NLP package, and it has an inbuilt corpus for named entity extraction. And I'm importing that corpus. It's spacy.load does that. And then what I'm going to do is, I'm taking that soup object that I have created. I am finding all H2 tags. So the heading 2 tags is what I am finding. So what it will go is, it will go to the website and scan through all H2 tags. Basically for each website, how the website is constructed, you may have a different tag. But the CNN website, if you right click and view the source, you can see all the headlines coming in H2 tag. Right, so I'm taking all the H2 tag. I'm iterating it over here, and what I'm doing is I'm printing the kind of the text over here, and within that I'm printing the entities that are talked about. So the entities can be like if a company is talking about Apple, then Apple is the entity, and Apple is basically an organization. If a country is talked about, USA is the entity, and basically the label over there is a geopolitical entity. It's an country. They are internally it's defined as geopolitical entity. Let me run this and show so that you get a better idea. So if you see the output, in this case, if you see like House plans to move coronavirus bill quickly tonight when an agreement is reached. So it's telling House is an organization, and tonight is a time, right? Similarly, like US Southern Command says, US Southern Command is an organization, and it talks about Brazilian president visit. So Brazilian is an kind of NORP, right? So you can, and similarly, if you see Cleveland, it's Cleveland Cavaliers is an organization, 10,000 is an money, NBA is an organization. So Illinois is an geopolitical entity. It's a location, it's calling it a geopolitical entity, that's why. Right, so that's what we are doing here now. Now, this is a simple example of how you can go to an URL and how I can extract it. But if I want to get a news about it, I want to go to 10 different websites. Maybe in each country, I want to go to a website and scrap data from there. Right? So how I can do from multiple websites. So here, what I'm doing is, I am also defining a couple of other URLs. I'm defining the NBC website that showed you that URLs. It does not have any special date tag. And I am also defining the CNBC RSS URL, which is an XML output that it gives. And then I'm creating a list of URLs. In this, I'm giving the URL NBC URL, CNN URL, and CNBC RSS URL. And apart from that, I'm telling the format for each. So how it is, I'm creating four lists. And each CNN URL is in HTML format. The H2 tag I has to extract, and the website is CNN. Right, NBC URL is an HTML tag. I need to again extract the H2 tag, and it's an NBC website. Right. So what I'm doing is I'm telling the format of each particular URL. I'm telling the tags that I need to extract. If you take the third one, the RSS URL, that is a CNBC. Here, what I'm telling is my output is an XML type, not a HTML type. Right. And I'm telling description is the tag I need to extract, and I'm just giving a name. It's CNBC. Right, so that's what I am defining over here. So I have defined all the URLs, I have defined all the formats I want to extract. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to iterate for each and every URL use the beautiful soap, I extract the content, and then create a pandas data frame. Before that, I will print the output so that you can see it. So show you over here. So what I'm doing is I'm creating an just crawl length object, right? I'm doing like for URL in URLs. So all this URLs object on the top, I'm just iterating through one by one. And I'm just printing like crawling web page, whatever, like first I'm doing CNN, second I'm doing NBC. And I'm telling request.getURL, whatever you saw in the previous one, like we are just doing a request.getURL and passing the response, the HTML response to an beautiful soap constructor. And here I'm telling the format. So format of crawl length. So crawl length is zero. I will keep incrementing it. So when I am accessing the zero index for CNN URL, the format will be HTML. When I'm accessing the second index of CNBC, the format will be XML, right? That's what I'm doing. And then what I'm doing is I'm getting this soup object and I'm going to find all tags. So tags similarly, I'll find the H2 tag in case of CNN. I'll find the description tag in case of CNBC. So basically, that's what I am doing over here. And I am also making sure I am the final text I am getting, right? It should be at least of 4 words. So sometimes you may get just like live update going on. I don't want that. I want it at least to be of 4 words. So that's what I am doing is I'm taking the text that I'm getting in the link. And I am splitting it by space and just checking whether it's greater than 4. If it is less than 4, I want to ignore it. And then I am printing the headline and I am printing the entities. So for entities, I'm just calling the whatever same method, right? The NLP is the spacy object. I'm calling the text, the link.text is the link I get, the text object within it. I'm getting all the entities. I am iterating to the entity. I'm just printing what are the entities that have been talked about and what are the labels. And finally, I'm incrementing the crawl length I am checking. So what will happen after every iteration, it will increment the crawl length so that I can go to the next object in the list. So if you see the output over here, it's going to all 3 websites and it's printing. So if you take one example over here, the Capitol will be closed to the public for rest of the month. The White House tour will stop indefinitely. So Capitol is an organization. The month is the date and White House is an organization again. Similarly, the Canadian e-commerce company. So Canadian is an NORC. March 16th is the date. So you can see basically it is taking this is a text that is coming from the website. And this is the named entity classifier that we have run, right? That's what we are doing here. Now, what we'll do is we will take this and put it into a pandas data frame so that we have a data frame that we can combine and that we can run it. So now what I'm doing is I'm doing the same thing, right? I have removed all the print statement. Rather, I am setting the crawl length. I'm setting a news dictionary, a dictionary object over here. And then I am similarly iterating the URL in URLs. I'm doing the request.getURL, the same function. I am using the beautiful soap object. And then I'm again setting the format. I am iterating through all the find all tags over here, similar to what we did in the previous one. The only difference is rather than iterating the entity, I have created a list comprehension and where I'm telling like for entities in the NLP text, extract the NLP entity text and label. So the text can be country and label can be what it represents, a geopolitical entity in this case, right? So that's what I'm doing and I'm assigning it to an entities list, right? And finally, the news dictionary object I created, I am appending everything. I'm appending website. Website is what I've defined on the top. I'm appending the URL that I am getting over here. The URL is basically this one. I'm getting the headlines, which is the link.text object. And then I'm getting the entities, which is the dictionary object, right? So that's what I'm doing. Let me quickly run this and I will show the output. So this is run and then the news dictionary. So you can see basically, this is basically one dictionary object. Right, it says the entities in this case. The headline is I didn't think it was a likely outcome. Dallas Mavericks owner basically told CNBC on Thursday. Right, so Dallas Mavericks is a geopolitical entity. Maybe it's wrong because Dallas is a state, that's why it's telling it. That can be mistake by Spacy, right? Spacy is not completely perfect. Mark Cuban is a person, CNBC is an organization, Thursday is a date. Similarly, this is one dictionary object. Similarly, you have a lot of dictionary object. Now to make it better, I'm going to put it in a pandas data frame. So I'm going to import pandas and I'm passing the news dictionary into and pandas data frame and assigning it to news DF. And let me print it. Now you can see it better. So what it is telling is I have basically if you go on the top, I have website CNN and then URL is this one, and basically headline what you need to know. That's what their headline is. There's no entity here, but here it says, okay, Arlington National Cemetery will be closed to visitors beginning Friday, right? That's the coronavirus news they have. It's telling the organization and date. Then a Brazil president says he expects results from his coronavirus test in next hours. So Brazil is a geopolitical entity. Next hour is a time. So basically it has created a structured pandas data frame for us, but the last column over here is a list column now. So we can either directly use it and analyze it when we want it. But what I can do is I can even break the list object. So to break the list object, what I am doing is I am using this to break the list object, the newsds.applyPandasCDS. So I'm taking the entities and then I'm applying as a pandas CDS. So it will kind of break it. And again, concatenating it with the website URL headline from the top data frame, I'm doing a PD concat. So if you see the output over here, basically what it's going to do is it's going to have the same data frame as top. In this case, if you see over here, either website, URL and headline, but the entities, the named entities is extracted as multiple columns. So I have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, depending on the number of entities, maximum number of entities and particular news has, it will create that many columns and then extract it separately so that it's easy for you to analyze. So what we saw in this case is basically we are going to the bottom one, the web crawling part, and then crawling all the data and then building our data frame. Now we have the social media data frame. We have the actual data from the John Hopkins repo, which is completely cleaned and prepared. And then we have the web crawling data. So now what we can do is we can generate more insights when we are creating a dashboard where we can show who are the people who are talking about, which countries most commenting on the Twitter, what are the countries that are pretty much talked in the web news and everything. So that will give you a better idea like where most of the new cases are getting found, and if there is travel restriction, you can build a bubble chart of all the words that are coming in, and you can represent the data better, and you can basically show it as your portfolio. Right. So that's about it in this video. I will try to basically merge everything together and show a final visualization or something if possible in the future videos. Thank you.